Welcome back to Let's Read Dread, and today we have something special. We've actually reached the end of the case files for the first book, but at the end of the book, we actually have bonus materials. So we're going to start on the bonus materials, and we have the first Dread, which was a script by Pat Mills and John Wagner, and the art was by Carlos Esquivera, or Esquera. I don't know how to pronounce that. Square, maybe? Anyway, the story is printed here mainly to show the original art. It also contains evidence of Dread acting in his role of judge, jury, and executioner, the side of his character that was cut out. And then there are some Walter the Wobot episodes. The script is by Joe Collins, art by Brad Boland. The first Dread was actually not published. The Walter the Wobots were published. They were published on programs 50 through 58. So we've got a few of those to get through. Oh boy. My favorite character with his very own strip. Yay! Anyway, so let's get into this. So this is the very first Dread. Megacity Law Control to Judge Dread. Oh, I see. This is supposed to be a radio control. Megacity Law Control to Judge Dread. Bank raid in New Manhattan. Street level 95. Lawbreakers about to escape. And in the top panel, we can see some guys shooting the place up. There's one guy that's got, or maybe it's a robot they have that has a fire jet that's burning people. And we see crashing through, we don't know, a window, a wall. No one can escape justice! Oh, and it's a big double panel one, okay. Oh, look out! It's Judge Dredd! Smoke him! Lawbreakers like these running wild. Somebody's got to stamp it out. That's my job. I'm a judge. To bring down the high crime rate in America's vast megacities, judges have been appointed with the power to hand out instant justice. Each judge is picked to be fair, but tough. Toughest of them all is Judge Dredd. You may be a judge, but you may be a judge, but you ain't sentencing us, Dread. There's a meter of steel between us. Each judge is armed with a special gun loaded with six kinds of shell. Dread flipped the switch to number 3. A rubber titanium ricochet shell will flush those lawbreakers out. Yeah, that 6 meter thick steel ain't gonna help you much there, buddy. Oh, I'm sorry, meter thick. The ricochet shell whizzed around the vault. Oh no, Dredd's using dodgems on us! Ah! No more, we surrender! There is no surrender. You killed 6 innocent people. Onto the sidewalk where I shall carry out your sentence. I find you guilty of bank robbery and murder and hereby terminate you. One of the crowd yelled out excitedly, "Yeah, you give it to him, Judge!" I would remind you, citizen, I take no pleasure in terminating lawbreakers. And you have broken the law by stepping off the sidewalk. I sentence you to 400 days in the jaywalker chug. Oh my god, 400 days. The guy's kind of an asshat, but still. In this megacity, I'm sorry, I'm having to lean in because it's like really tiny. In this megacity of the future, all crimes, no matter how small, are dealt with sternly by the judges. The lawbreaker would be taken to a special prison jug. Let's not be hasty, Judge. Take all these credits and forget you ever saw me, huh? Oh, yeah, that's gonna go well for you. Bribing a judge, an odious offense. The lawbreaker's running around the corner. He won't escape. Judge Dredd flipped the switch on his gun to number 6. This calls for a heat-seeking shell. Ah! The shell sped after the lawbreaker, relentlessly homing on him. The judge climbed aboard his Lawmaster 5000 bimobile. Bimobile, really? That's kind of dorky. Justice has been done. Take over, Lieutenant. But very, very good, Judge. We can't tell if that's the end. Oh, no, here's the end. I'll carry on with my cleanup patrol. Only those who break the law have anything to fear from me. I am the law, and you'd better believe it. And that's the end of the first Dredd. And of course, this was never printed. I believe part of the story was that it was being worked on, but it was coming in late, and so, or they didn't like all of it, so they ended up not using it. But this is the very first episode of Judge Dredd ever written, but I don't know that it was ever actually printed anywhere besides in collections like this. And that's the end of that one, and next up we have the oh-so-horrible Walta the Wobot. Wend of Dwed. Oh, God. Oh, this is gonna hurt. Okay. Here we go. Judge Dredd, Marshal of Luna... Oh, good Lord, we're going back to Luna 1. Judge Dredd, Marshal of Luna 1 Moon Colony, is out on patrol. His faithful servo-robot Walter takes time for an oil bath. Invitation number... 2937A/1 to Luna Robot Fancy Dress Ball. Guest, Walter. God. Judge Dredd is nice to allow Walter to go out to the fancy dress ball. Walter will have a lovely boil in oil in preparation. What will I wear tonight? Something extravagant, perhaps. Oh, quipes, what a thing to do. What? Okay. Sorry, I'm trying to figure out what he's saying, oh, cripes, about. Okay. Luna. Oh. Luna, we pair. Sorry to trouble you, but I need a plumber. Your call is noted. And so... You did what? You lousy hunk of tin? I got my toe stuck in the tap. What a rude plumber. Plumber. Well, there's only one way out of this. Drock it. Walter, have you decided what to wear yet? Oh, I'm sorry. This is Judge Dredd talking to Walter. Drockett, Walter, have you decided what to wear yet? Yes, Judge Dredd. I'm going as Fred Astaire. I wed somewhere that he was a remarkable tap dancer. Oh, man. And we see he's still got the tap stuck on his toe. Next episode. Oh man. These are hard to get through. Walter the Wobot, friend of Judge of Dwed. Ugh. You're purposefully doing this to me, you bastards. Walter had a great idea for killing time after a hard day's work on Luna 1. Pool. Robosport is what it says on his bag. Nice Judge Dwed keeps telling Walter to go drown himself. Walter is looking forward to a swim. Oh, Lord. Changing rooms are very crowded. There's no privacy for a respectable robot. Walter will complain to the manager after a refreshing dip. Geronimo! Crikey! What's the game, buddy? Walter, not in swimming pool. Walter made a boo-boo. Hi, guys. Ministry of Sport. Stress survey test. Afraid this table has failed. However, it will be replaced following a written report. When Judge Dwed sees this, Walter had better find a proper pool and stay until he rusts. Oh, man. Next program, Walter's brother. Walter the Robot, Walter the Wobot, friend of Dwed. One evening, while Walter was feeling really tired, too tired to watch his own screen, and he's drinking oil aid, apparently. Welcome to the Interplanetary News. A startling robbery at Luna Bank 6 this afternoon. A bank security film showed the robber to be a robot. The daredevil first tied up the manager and then proceeded to call him rude names. And we can see that it's "I'm Walter, try me" on his face, his nameplate. He later made off with 3 million groats. The heavy metal maniac apparently called Walter Squirt, pursuing judges with oil and these are so awful. Squirt, pursuing judges with oil. He gave us the slip, said one. Good grief. Walter's been at home all day, ironing Judge Dwed's underwear. Walter's innocent. Okay. Some rascal robot impersonating me. Judges will search. Find I belong to nice Judge Dwed. The note on the table says, "Dear Judge Dwed, it's a flame up. Walter, P.S. Dinner's in the fridge." Oh. Walter in trouble and had better scram. Wait, though, I will need a disguise or I will be recognized. So Walter's walking down the street and there's wanted signs. Where will I find refuge so I can prove my innocence? Will Judge Dwed ever repair my rusty joints again? Find out next program in Night of the Mugger. Next program, Night of the Mugger. The dark alleyways of Luna 1 haunt the dark alleyways of Luna 1, the haunt of hardened criminals, the den of despicable dropouts, the refuge of rundown rejects, and Walter. Walter does not like being on the one, wishes he could tell Judge Webb that what Wharton scoundrel pretends to be Walter.
Psst! Hey, pal, seen any cops?
No.
Good, stick 'em up or I'll deactivate ya.
Oh, quipes, a mugger with a screwdriver. Please don't take Walter's precious bag, anything but that.
Precious, eh? What? Thousands of press cutting about that crumb dread?
Judge Dredd is no qualm. He is great and brave. Don't you take away Walter's memories of him.
Listen, Fate, you're that robot the fuzz is after. There's a tiny pile of credits in reward for your carcass, alive or deactivated.
Heads off, creep. Oh no, hands off, creep. He's mine, you old buzzard. Walt and me got a score to settle. Next program, The Bubbly Death. Walter was on the run. Sorry. Walter was on the run from a bank robbery he did not commit. After being mugged in a dark Luna alley, he faced a strange rescuer.
Quipes, it's the scoundrel who's been impersonating Walter.
Me and Walt got things to discuss, fella, and you ain't invited, dig?
Boop. No, I didn't. No, don't fire that thing. It's a splurge gun.
The gun says Sudzo on the side of it.
Ha ha ha! You should have brought your rubber duck.
You drown him, you water.
Shut up. Bums like him deserve the bubbly death. He ain't had a bath in years.
Quill Rascal, who are you? Cough. How dare you rob banks pretending to be Walter? Cough.
So you ain't guessed yet. We were assembled on the same day. Remember?
And the guy takes off the Try Me, I'm Walter Try Me plate and says, it says, Gus rules, okay?
Gracious, Gus, Walter's brother.
Let's see. No spitting on sidewalk, penalty 5 cents, says the sign.
That's right, creep. Now you're coming with me.
Walter refuses.
You ain't changed, Walt. You're still the same old drag.
As he drags Walter along, titty boom. Sorry about that. And I accidentally flipped the page.
Judge Dredd will get you for this. You wait.
Oh, no. Sorry.
Judge Dredd will get you for this, you wet.
What grim fate awaits our metal hero? Next program, the origin of Walter. Ugh. The Origin of Walt. Walter the Robot and Walter the Wobot in a new font. Alright. A space station on Luna 1. Walter is... Okay. Walter is the prisoner of his tough brother, Gus, and Gus does not mess about.
Walter's brother, a criminal, disgraceful. Walter regrets being activated.
And the sign on the fence says, Interglobal Hardware Company, we order, you order, we deliver.
That's right, and from the day we was assembled, you had it made. You were a popular, well-loved drink dispenser, and me, a crummy, boring adding machine. But I was ambitious, determined to go places. I studied while you read stupid comics.
And Walter's reading a Judge Dredd daily comic.
And what happened? I'm assigned to research moon rocks. While you land a job on Easy Street. When I heard you were visiting Luna with Judge Dredd, I hit on my revenge. Robbing banks disguised as you. Gangway creeps. Now all I got to do is turn you in. Dredd will probably give me your job for that. Judge Dredd will not believe you. Walter will reveal all. In that case, you're dead, brother. I'll say you fell in during the struggle. Oh, Quikey.
Next program. Next program. Death of a Wobot. It's bad enough listening to Walter talk. Stop putting it in the captions and titles. We've got the next episode of Walter the Wobot. They say a dying robot's program flashes before it, the moment before deactivation. Walt is no exception.
Soon I'll be rid of you forever, then I'll claim your cushy job with Dredd. Scandal, Walter will return to haunt you.
And Walter's being run into the reject robot deactivator, scrap metal.
Hey, what happened? The crummy conveyor belt stopped. Kersher bolts, get moving. Ouch, you naughty boy, Gus. Who said that? I did. Release your brother instantly.
I don't know what voice to be using there. Okay.
In you go, you disgusting boy. Org!
Later. Bye.
Bye, Walter. Your reputation is safe now. And give Judge Dredd my little present. White O, mummy. Sniff. Walter is very grateful. Judge Dredd will appreciate a transistor radio, even if it did once warp banks.
And it looks like the tag says reprogrammed criminal robot. And I guess it says Gus turn me on, okay?
Next program, Radio Walt.
God, there's so many of these. And here we have on Walter the Wobot. Somewhere on Luna 1. And the guy is wearing a hat that says Pirate Radio Funk.
Hi, Pop Pickers. This is OG Noxious, your Pirate Luna DJ with tonight's mystery guest.
Greetings.
Oh, say a few words for our listeners, pal.
Greetings.
Attaboy, we've screened our first caller. Who do you think it is, citizen?
Sounds like some kind of freak.
Is it, sorry, pal, your time is up.
And, this guy in the frame, with all the weird shit on his clothes, it says, I am a mump. I don't know what the hell that is. Whatever.
Kiddies, you are gonna dread hearing the right answer. Hint, hint. Some music, Mr. X?
White on, here's my favorite track. Which is dedicated to dear Judge Dwed.
Far out, but we have a hotline call. That means a leading citizen. Hello, citizen. Your mystery guest is...
Oh, I'm sorry.
Hello, citizen. Your mystery guest is Walter. And the big idiot is helping you break the law. Radio Funk broadcasting. Radio Funk is broadcasting without a license. Your fine is 1 million credits.
Good gracious, Judge Dwed.
And we can see Pirate Radio Funk Man in the back putting a gun to his head.
This is Walter closing down Radio Funk on behalf of OB Noxious. He just gone bankrupt.
God.
Next program, quiz show.
Oh, so many of these, they're awful. That's why I'm doing them all in one slug, so you don't have to watch weeks of Walter the Wobot. All right, the quiz show appears to be Master Brain.
Good evening and welcome to Master Brain, a game of quick wits and general knowledge. I'm Magnus Magnanimous. Tonight our contestants are...
Is that a brain? Ew.
Herman Schickeldriver, interior decorator.
Good evening.
Oh man, he's even got the Hitler stash. That's...
Bridget LaBoob! Actress! Hi, honey!
Hello, handsome.
Julian Pitchfork! Lecturer on moon rocks! And Walter, the servo robot!
Greetings.
Walter, you're first. What is your subject?
Judge Dwed.
You have 2 megaseconds to answer the first question on Judge Dredd. Starting now. What is his favorite expression?
Dwocket.
Correct. What color socks does he wear on Sundays?
Stop. This cheating has gone on far enough. He is the robot. Robots can answer anything.
Interruptions are forbidden, Schickeldriver. Careful of the crocodiles down there.
Arr!
Later, as Walt received the Golden Brain, it is a brain, ew, the Golden Brain Award.
Congratulations, Walt, you won!
But how?
Well, we robots have to stick together.
Clank. Next program, Monster. Okay. Okay, that I think that's the end of the Walter the Robots, and these are actually 2000 AD covers that were used. So here's the cover for the Robot Revolt with Call Me Kenneth. And there's a bunch of them in here. You can see there's a Star Wars photo review inside. Lovely! Okay, well, I'm not going to comment on every color there, cover. There we go. So next time we'll pick up with Omnibus 2. I hope you enjoyed that bit. Next time we'll get back into the actual Judge Dredds. Thanks for reading.